battle that continues, but they've come out behind Pibo Turani. So Pibo Turani has definitely jumped those two. Now, who else went through? Felipe Albuquerque went through and Scott Pruitt's gone through. So Pibo Turani has gone up at least a third position up by my reckoning. Albuquerque has gone through, I reckon, to lead the motor race again. And that's confirmed as he crosses the timing line at the end of the first sector. So it's 5 and 31 by still 6 seconds. And Big Pibo Turani, who comes through in third, who is only another 6 seconds further back, he's taken more than a second out of them that lap around. And they've gone back onto wet with a sky that is lightening. And I don't mean thunder and lightning, I mean it is getting lighter. Wow, now we've got a battle, Jeremy.
Yeah, it's
very well done by those guys. Let me run through the other categories. We are, as you might imagine, very excited about what's going on at the front of the GTLM. Nick Tandy, the 9-1, one of the leading teammate by 10 seconds, Michael Christensen, the 9-1-2. And then it's Scott Dixon for Ford, the 67 car, who is another 45 seconds further back. In PC, Colin Brown, we've documented that, ahead of Robin Alond by, quite a lot, nearly a full lap actually. Sharp end of a full lap anyway, so that's 57 seconds, half a lap should I say. Then in GT Daytona, Corey Lewis in the Lamborghini number 16 is now 17 and a half seconds ahead of new second place, the Audi number 9. That's Matt Bell, Madison Snow in third, another 5-6 seconds further back. So does that mean that the Audi pitted then, the 63, as it did, and Alexander Balsan has jumped in to the number 63 car, which holds fourth position. Philippe Albuquerque on his first flying lap on wet tyres, a 2:14.9, 2:14.6 by Scott Pruitt. Pibo Turani, 2:11.4, and he's now less than 3 seconds behind the Action Express number 31 car, with traffic playing a part as well. That Mustang sampling Action Express car does look very, very purposeful indeed. It's a simple but effective colour scheme. Love the black stripe down the roof and over the rear engine cover, of the rear of the car, across the engine cover. Simple piece of black striping down the front and sides with that yellow accent. DP cars have really come of age in terms of their styling, looking better now than they ever have. And we wait with bated breath as to what will happen with the new LMP2 chassis with manufacturer bodywork, the DP Internationals. Not too far away, Dan Hansel coming up with a stunning design as part of the Midweek Motorsport Listeners Collective for the Nissan, which we believe...
Here's number 16 car.
That's the leader in GTT.
And what a great job Corey Lewis has done.
Mega.
Superb.
Mega job. Easily going to keep the lead on the rotation, Jeremy, because he pulled out such a gap. The Ferrari pitted a little bit earlier. Balsam back in the pit lane. Right, wasn't expecting that. That car can't have been in very long and cool. So the top four in GTD all pitting. Andrew Davies in the number 6 will benefit from this. And Nick Tandy's in the pit as well, which means he will give up the lead in GTLM, which he has done to... No, Christensen's followed him in. So it'll be Scott Dixon when he comes across the line. Shears a portion.
It will be Kevin Estra taking over for Nick Tandy. Kevin getting his first laps around Sebring in the wet and his first laps in the race in the factory car. But yes, Nick Tandy has gotten out the 912, also in no driver change for that one, though, as they are doing new Michelin tires onto was Nick Tandy's car, what now is Kevin Estrus' car. I think they were slicks, but I will need to double check with them. Also, a little bit earlier on, both Corvettes came in, the three ahead of the four, but the four beat the three back out because it did not do a driver change when the three did. I'm also waiting to find out what tires they put on as well.
Two Porsches down and a rear faction. Now, Scott Dixon came in the Ford at the same time. So who's the next GTLM? Oh, that would be Kuno Wittmer. And he hasn't quite crossed the line yet, so that hasn't quite paid off for them. Lost a bit of time when it got a bit wetter, and he's not really got down to those times again, the 23.9 last time around. So Estra and Christensen now, the two Porsche drivers, as Christensen steers in. Kevin Estra in the 9-1-1. Pipo Durrani. Oh, now what's happened to Pipo? He's had a very, very slow lap, a 2.22, and dropped a heap of time. He's dropped back to 9, nearly 10 seconds away from Scott Pruitt when he was just a couple of seconds behind.
Josh Norman, who's taken over from Carl Marcelli.
Yeah, that's not really great room for that car.
They were running fairly well. They just made a pit stop a couple of laps ago.
We'll see where people lost the time. 2.22 and now a 2.20. Well, maybe it's just wetter out on the far side of the circuit, Jeremy, because a 2.20.3 by Scott Pruitt as well.
Yeah, and Albuquerque pulled out nearly 5 seconds on Scott Pruitt that lap.
Yeah, it must be slippery somewhere, yeah. It's either more slippery in more places or super slippery in one spot. Well, that number 8 car was very lucky indeed there. He reversed the lock, got it pointing in the right direction, and then didn't overcorrect.
There's that big slide by Josh Norman.
It's in the 8th car.
6th car, Andrew Davis. On pit lane, they just made a pit stop.
No, they're just out of sync by a lap or two with the top four. So Nick Johnson will be leading for a wee while in the 45 Flying Lizard Audi in GTD. And let's go down to Shea Adam for some tyre news.
Porsches did go on wets, Corvettes went on slicks, and as if it wouldn't be confusing enough, BMW right now, they have a set of wets, but they also have a set of slicks immediately behind it, so that's going to be a game-time decision.
And this is for the 25 car, presumably, or is this for both cars?
Both cars.
Right, Kuno did really good job on in the early part of his stint. Oh, one of the Corvettes has picked up an advertising hoarding from somewhere. Does that mean the number 4 of Marcel Fesler has been off the circuit? We saw him take the long way around at the hairpin a wee while ago, but I don't think he would have picked that up from there. We've got a left rear puncture for the Ford. Now, which one is it?
It's a 66.
Oh, well, at least they're getting all the bad luck for Ford this weekend. It is behind the wheel of that at the moment. Sebastian Bourdais, we put in that car, didn't we? And his experience will have to get him round about half a lap before he can get service. Beautiful design, that car, very clever. It even has air ducts out under, or should I say through, the rear light, the two roundels. Number 4 Corvette comes into the pit lane for Marcel Fesler, ostensibly to remove that, to remove the advertising holding from the front. It'll be overheating terribly if he doesn't get rid of that shit.
It looks like it's actually caused some damage too. Just as he drove past me, I could see that the sign was actually pushed in to the front grille of the Corvette, so that's body damage as well.
He's gone off at the hairpin again, but no, he hasn't. That is turn 10. And he got away with it.
Three car.
Oh, that's the 3 car, excuse me. Yes, that's Magnussen who's been off as well.